สวัสดีค่ะ Very good evening and welcome to Thai PBS World Tonight. I'm Nan Bunag.
I'm Philip Nai Somphop Lau.
We'll begin tonight with the latest on the COVID-19 situation in Thailand, as today the country recorded up to 98 COVID-19 related deaths, and this is the highest daily death toll since the pandemic began last year, and this brings the death toll since the latest wave in April to almost 3,000. Thailand also recorded 9,186 new infections today, raising the cumulative total in the latest outbreak to about 343,000. At the same time, 5,543 patients have recovered from the disease. The daily infections in Bangkok remain at over 2,000 cases over the past week. At the same time, over 103,000 people across the country are undergoing treatment for COVID-19 at the moment, which is also at its all-time high. About 3,200 of them are in serious conditions. Meanwhile, the National Health Security Office, or the NHSO, has opened another facility to provide free COVID-19 testing with rapid antigen test kits for members of the public to ease the workload on the two existing testing centers. The NHSO Secretary General, Dr. Janet Thammathat Ari, said that the new facility, which opens from today until July 21st from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., is located at the Princess Mother National Institute on Drug Abuse Treatment, or the Thanyorang Institute, on Wipawadi Rangsit Road, Rangsit Highway in Pathum Thani Province, and will have the capacity to test 5,000 walk-ins each day without charge. The free COVID-19 testing service is the result of a joint effort by the NHSO, the Thanyorang Institute, and Mahara Nakhon Ratchasima Hospital. Those who want to get tested are required to show their ID cards to officials at the facility. Dr. Janet also said that if anyone tests positive for the disease, NHSO officials will arrange for them to enter home or community isolation. Mahara Nakhon Ratchasima Hospital's director, Dr. Kriengsak Wacharakunkiet, said that the hospital would send 10 medics, including a doctor, to help in providing the testing service. The three existing testing facilities at Thupathaimi Stadium in Don Mueang area, the Ratchamongkala Stadium in Huamak, and the government complex on Zhang Watana Road, jointly operated by the NHSO, the Urban Institute for Disease Prevention and Control, and the Faculty of Medical Technology of Mahidol University, have been packed every day as the number of people showing up exceeds the daily limit of 3,000 tests.
So let's hope that all these new sites opening up will help ease the backlog of the testing site.
Right.
Now today, let's talk about Samui Island, because Samui has opening up itself to the foreign arrivals. The first day today, it's the scheme that called Samui Plus. It's a little bit different from Chiang Mai Sandbox. Samui Plus will have a little more restriction on the first 7 days. It's kickoff today for the fully vaccinated foreign tourists, and it's just 2 weeks after Samui Sandbox kickoff. And the first group of tourists arrived this morning was 20 people. The once bustling atmosphere of Smui's Chowing remains quiet due to the COVID-19 pandemic. However, many locals believe that Smui Plus reopening model will begin the revival of tourism-based local economy. President of the Samui Tourism Promotion Association, Ratchapon Bunsawat, expects more tourists to visit the island later in the year if the COVID-19 situation eases. He said that the COVID-19 situation is still a problem, so it might be a challenge to promote tourism. Many businesses on the island believe that the tourism might pick up in the fourth quarter. So many hotel owners and staff are closely monitoring the situation as it remains unpredictable. The Samui Pass model welcomes fully vaccinated foreign tourists onto the island. They will get a swab test at the airport on arrival and will have to enter quarantine at pre-booked SHA Plus certified hotels. For the first 7 days, tourists must remain in their hotel's compound before their second swab test. For the second week of their stay, they can travel around Samui, Pangan, and Tao Island while continuing to stay at SHA Plus certified venue. But in those first 7 days, actually on day 5 to day 7, they can travel to some certain place outside the hotel but have to be the place under the control of the Samui authority. Let's say if you want to have some massage, there'll be like 1, 2, 3, 4 places for you to pick on that under the perimeter that they allowed. So far, 17 hotels in the Samui Plus projects are SHA Plus certified with almost 500 rooms available. The initiative is helping 10% of the hospitality sector's workforce to return to work. However, as they launch the Samui Plus model, authorities are also having to keep a close watch on the COVID-19 situation. Daily infections in Thailand are now soaring close to 10,000, with nearly 100 deaths, as the highly transmissible Delta variant takes hold. So if Samui's relaxed quarantine rules spark new cluster, the model will be adjusted and perhaps even canceled in the worst case scenario. For instance, stories said that if the number of infection rises above 20, or if there are more than 3 clusters in 2 weeks period, or within the 14 day, the alternative quarantine will be imposed on all visitors. So if the number of infection rises to above 40 or starts spreading uncontrollably, Samui disease control authorities will have the right to suspend or cancel the model. So let's hope it won't happen that way. Let's hope that this Samui Plus will be a successful scheme and then it will help start the revival of the tourism on the island.
Definitely. And now let's move on to another issue with the vaccinations. We've been hearing about the mix and match types of COVID-19 vaccines. So let's say if you've been inoculated with Sinovac vaccines, the second dose will be AstraZeneca. Or especially with the medics, if you receive both doses of Sinovac, then there's a possibility that you'll be taking either AstraZeneca or another mRNA vaccine as a booster dose. However, at the beginning of this week, the WHO actually warned that this move can be very dangerous. However, today, a World Health Organization representative says that the WHO is actually not against Thailand's decision to use a mix and match vaccination approach, whereby a shot of AstraZeneca vaccine is administered after 1 or 2 shots of Sinovac vaccine. Speaking at a meeting of an academic committee held yesterday to discuss the National Communicable Disease Committee's approval of the practice, acting WHO representative to Thailand, Dr. Renu Madalo Garg, stated that the choice of vaccines depends on the government's policy and the COVID-19 situation if public health sectors in each country are supporting research. Referring to the WHO's chief scientist's remarks on Monday that the practice is dangerous when individuals decide for themselves without sufficient data available, Dr. Renu said it was only a general suggestion. She also recommended close monitoring for possible side effects and urged accelerated vaccination of people aged 60 and over and those with any of the 7 specified diseases. The academic committee has agreed to the NCDC's decision by which those who receive Sinovac as their first dose can be vaccinated with AstraZeneca for their second, with 3 to 4 weeks in between, and that the AstraZeneca vaccine or any mRNA vaccines can be used as a third booster shot for medical personnel, most of whom have received 2 doses of Sinovac, the efficacy of which in fending off the increasingly dominant Delta variant is being questioned. Among those present at the meeting and agreeing to the mix and match approach were Deputy Director General of the Disease Control Department, Dr. Sopon Iem Sirik Tawon, and Dr. Somwang Dan Chai Vichit, the head of the academic committee, who confirmed that the mix and match of vaccines is based on research conducted in Thailand, which has been approved by the domestic academic committee and experts. However, it remains unclear when the practice will begin, prompting some vaccination sites, such as in Chiang Mai, to temporarily halt vaccinations pending clarity. Meanwhile, the Jullapon Royal Academy has announced that anyone living in the 10 maximum control and restricted provinces, or the so-called dark red provinces, can subscribe for Sinopharm vaccinations this Sunday from 8 o'clock in the morning through the CRA Sinop app instead of today as originally planned. The Jullapon Royal Academy Secretary General, Dr. D.T. Mahanon, apologized for the sudden postponement due to technical difficulties, saying that bookings will open on Sunday and only 40,000 will be accepted.
Okay, so seems like every institute is trying their best to help what's going on in Thailand right now.
Definitely.
And the latest report about the favipiravir tablets that Thailand has been using for treatment for the COVID-19 patient. Right now, the Ministry of Public Health has procured an additional 16 million tablets of those to treat COVID-19 patients, which are expected to arrive in Thailand this month. Dr. Karakrit Lim Somut, director of the Health Administration Division, said that there are currently 4 million favipiravir tablets and 1,613 vials of remdesivir broad spectrum antiviral intravenous medication on hand, and the arrival of a new shipment will ensure that there is sufficient medication to meet current requirements. He added that if there is a need for more, the medications can be procured quickly because the ministry has direct contact with the drugs manufacturers. Dr. Concrete revealed that the ministry's Centers for the Management of Medicines and Pharmaceutical Products, which was recently formed to cope with the COVID-19 pandemic, has also procured more PPE equipment for medics, including N95 face masks, coveralls and gowns, shoe covers, hoods, face shields, leg covers, surgical masks, nitrite and disposable gloves. Dr. Witthun Anankun, the director of the Emergency Health Division, said that 20 to 24% of hospital beds for green patients or asymptomatic or mild symptoms patients are currently unoccupied, as are 6% of beds for yellow patients, which is those who develop short, rapid breathing, fatigue, or suffer from one of the named underlying diseases. In managing hospital beds, to ensure that those who need them the most can be admitted, he said that the quality of the facilities of the green patients who are asymptomatic or have mild symptoms need to be improved. So there will be more beds in hospitals for moderate and severe cases. Meanwhile, it is reported that some pharmacies are experiencing a shortage of Vitalite Zone Thai traditional herbal medicine, recently approved by the Public Health Ministry for the treatment of mild symptoms associated with COVID-19 infection, such as headache, cough, and sore throat. Pharmacist Bawon Ang Sukhawanit told Thai PBS that buyers are stocking up the herbal medicine as a precaution, to the extent that his pharmacy is out of stock, adding that finger root, which is claimed to be effective in reducing COVID symptoms, is also in great demand and is getting scarce. He said that the price of bottle of Vitalite Zone tablets has increased to 100 baht from 90 baht last week, and it is selling like hotcakes. So Mrs. Sopi Bopan, the head of community-based enterprise engaged in cultivating herbs in Ratchaburi province, said that the price of the dried Phatthalaijo leaves has increased from 25,000 baht to 40,000 baht per ton due to the sudden high demand. So yes, price is going up. Right now it's only 10%, but who knows if people start stocking it up themselves, the price might go up, or like there's a period last year that it become a little more difficult to find.
Exactly, and with the Phatthalaijo medicine, it has always been discussed since the start of the pandemic up until now. And some patients are already using them, especially those who are experiencing mild symptoms of COVID-19, or they think they might have those symptoms. They have already tried this medicine already. So we will find out more about this herbal medicine and how it can really cure mild COVID-19 patients.
54-year-old Pakakrong Rem Jarun caught COVID-19 in the middle of June this year and was one of the patients who was treated with Phatthalaijo. When taken for 5 consecutive days, as recommended by a doctor, her lungs did not become infected. She believes that she survived the infection because of this traditional medicine. Phatthalaijo is a well-known medicinal plant in Thailand. The leaves are traditionally used to make an exceedingly bitter tea to treat a number of illnesses, including fevers and infections. Now the poplar Thai herb is also being used in the treatment of mild COVID-19 symptoms in green-level patients who are not pregnant or breastfeeding and have no underlying diseases. The patient will receive a pack of 45 capsules of Phatthalaijo. 3 capsules are to be taken after breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Each dose contains 60 milligrams of andrographolide to help them fight the disease. Thai experts say the andrographolide in Phatthalaijo is effective in stopping the spread of the COVID-19 if given in large enough quantities and administered quickly after getting infected to prevent the virus from entering the lungs and causing pneumonia.
บางรายใช้ไม่ได้บางรายใช้อาจจะไม่ใช่โดสเท่านี้อะไรเงี้ยค่ะบางคนโดสจะแตกต่างกันต้องรู้ว่าใช้ยังไงใช้ให้ถูกมันถึงจะเป็นผลดีค่ะ
In the latest wave of the pandemic, numbers of new cases have hit a new high with almost 10,000 a day, and it is getting difficult to get tested, and the tests provided by private institutions are not affordable for many people. Many are camping on the streets of Bangkok, waiting to get queue numbers for the free test from the government. An expert suggests Phatthalaijo should just be given out to people who are at high risk of exposure to infection right away.
ในกลุ่มเสี่ยงสูงที่เราคาดว่าน่าจะติดเชื้อแล้วล่ะโอกาสติดเชื้อสูงมากถ้าเรามีการรักษาที่ราคาถูกพอถูกกว่าค่าตรวจนะคะแล้วก็ปลอดภัยมากพอคือรักษาไปแล้วไม่เกิดผลกระทบอะไรกับร่างกายกรณีเช่นนี้เนี่ยการรักษาไปเลยอาจจะคุ้มกว่าการมารอตรวจตรวจไปก็อาจจะไม่ได้บอกอะไรมากไปกว่านั้นเลยนะคะคาดการได้ว่าติดแน่กรณีนี้รีบรักษาซะเลย
Though Phatthalaijo is very affordable, it is out of stock in many pharmacies, while the price has gone up by around 10% due to the manufacturers increasing the price. Pharmacies are now allowing each customer to purchase only 1 bottle of Phatthalaijo capsules to prevent hoarding the sharply rising demand, with which production might not be able to keep up.
We have to admit that the Phatthalaijo herbal medicine is of high demand right now because of the worsening situation of the coronavirus.
And I think the suggestion from the expert is very interesting that he said, if you're not sure that a person will have the coronavirus or not, whether they're infected or not, and they has a very high chance that they will be infected, might as well just give them the fertilizer medicine because it's the cost is lower than taking the test itself. So I think it's a very interesting suggestion from him.
Great.
Now let's talk about the home isolation program that just kicked off in Thailand. The Department of Health has issued guidelines for home isolation, especially for those living with the COVID-19 patients. The Director General, Dr. Suwanchai Wattanayingjareunchai, explained that as the COVID-19 situation deteriorates, home isolation is necessary for patients while they are waiting to be admitted to hospitals. The guidelines include separate areas and keep 1 to 2 meters distance. If there's not enough space, use partitions between the isolating person and the other family members. Ensure the room has good ventilation and sunlight. Use separate towels, cutlery, glasses, and dishes. Wash clothes separately. If you cannot use separate bathrooms, the person self-isolating must be the last person to use the bathroom. Clean the bathroom using a wet cloth with bleach 0.1%, alcohol 70%, or hydrogen peroxide 0.5%. Prepare a rubbish bin with a lid, including personal items for the person in isolating, both in the bedroom and the bathroom. If you have only one bedroom, keep the bedroom door fully open to allow ventilation. Stay away from other family members and record your body temperature every day. See the doctor straight away if your body temperature rises above 37.5 degrees Celsius, accompanied by other symptoms such as breathing problems, pink eye, rashes, or blood oxygen levels fall below 95%. Those living with COVID-19 patients must wear face masks at all times. Wash their hands frequently with soap for at least 20 seconds. They should also separate all personal items, refrain from sharing meals or drinks, and keep a distance from the infected, especially in air-conditioned rooms. Washing clothes should be done separately, but drying can be on the same clothesline. Clean the house every day, including common areas where physical contact is frequent. Food must be fully cooked. Drink 6 to 8 glasses of water per day, rest well, and find activities to relieve stress. Remove all trash, including used face masks. Pour 2 liters of bleach on the trash before disposal. Then put all of the trash into another bag and hide it. Dr. Suwanchai also advised managers of condominiums and apartments to announce COVID-19 updates and guidelines, including disinfecting common areas, especially the stairs, elevators, doorknobs, mailboxes, chairs, gym equipment, as well as providing sanitizer gel in all common areas. So it's a lot of details, a lot of things you have to follow, but just have to work a little more to make sure that other people don't get infected or yourself don't get infected.
Yes, and this is all for the sake of the safety for all the other family members so that they don't get infected with the virus. And we're ending the program tonight with this story about pythons in one of the parks in Bangkok. So let's take a look.
Parkgoers in Bangkok looking for relief from renewed coronavirus restrictions got a slithering surprise on Thursday when a python as long as 2 of the Thai capital's ubiquitous mortarbites was spotted up in a tree. The reticulated python was only the latest big serpent to turn up in the densely populated center of Bangkok, where urban sprawl eating into natural habitats has been blamed for a rise in snake sightings in recent years. This one was found in Banjarsiri Park, which is flanked by towering hotels, apartment buildings, and several high-end shopping malls that are largely off-limits due to new restrictions put in place this week to stem a surge in virus. coronavirus cases. As joggers rounded a nearby running path, firefighters were called in to help park staff capture the snake. The python plotted its escape, heading for a building on the edge of the park that houses the World Fellowship of Buddhas, but firefighters were there waiting for it. One used a stick to grab the python by the neck and another tried to cut the branch it was on. They soon coaxed it into a sack and carried it away. Firefighter Song Chai Yusabai said the snake measured 3.5 meters long and weighed about 35 kilograms. He said his department alone has caught one or two snakes per day during the current rainy season, mostly in residential neighborhoods or houses with pets.
Well, with pythons, I'm pretty sure with the footage that we've been seeing, that's pretty scary. Despite the size, no matter whether it's like a big one or a small one, if anyone hates snakes to begin with, any size will be scary.
Okay, and that's wrap up. That's the last news of this edition of Thai PBS World Tonight. And if you want to know more about anything else happening in Thailand, including COVID, or politics, or even food tricks, you can check out our website, www.thaipbsworld.com. And we have other social media as well. We have YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, and Instagram.
Thanks for watching. Stay safe, and we'll see you tomorrow. สวัสดีค่ะ.
สวัสดีค่ะ.